Against our Bible study,
I
sign against the gadgets, I stand against the preacher and the interpreter. I stand against everyone of us this evening.
The Lord should put them into bondage. Every power I stand against our Bible study. Power I stand against our hearts. And whenever the message is going on, our hearts will be rubbing about. The Lord should cast those powers and put them into bondage. Let's command them to go into bondage. Every uninvited power.
And when
about
amen motor
powers in the sky,
power in the bush,
power that follow anybody here, any power at all, be it marine power or witchcraft power, from the beast of hell, anywhere they may gather against us,
if you give them back to the police,
to consume them, power assigned against the word of God in our lives. Power that will make the word of God to have no effect in our lives. That will make the word to fall on a rock ground. That will not allow the word to germinate in our lives. The Lord should consume them this evening. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. We want to pray and thank God.
I'm a
we are going to thank God.
I'm a
Holy Spirit of God. Holy Spirit of God. Come down and teach us your words. Open your mouth and pray. Let's pray that prayer in the name of Jesus. Let's pray with all our voices. Holy Spirit of God. We invite you this evening. We invite you this evening.
Let's open our mouth and talk to God. Holy Spirit of God. Teach me your word tonight. I will obey. I will follow. Open your mouth and talk to God. In Jesus' name we pray. Almighty God, we thank you for the grace you have given unto us to come to your presence. We thank you for how you have been helping us and how you have been opening our eyes to the truth. Father, open the eyes of our understanding. Holy Spirit, come and teach us by yourself. Thank you, Lord, because you have done it. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you, you can have your seat. This evening, we want to dig deeper into the word of God. We want to study the word of God. Because to live a victorious life, you need the word of God. That Ethiopian Enosh, he told Philip, he said, how can I understand except I have someone that will interpret it to me? If there is anything that we need in this end time, these are the people that are preacher of the mind of God. These are the people that will not do partiality and they will speak as the word of God has spoken. If there is anything we need in this end time, we need honest preaching. preacher.
I need a warning was to tell you, Koro.
Carry passion and zeal.
Someone be a car, no, at it.
And that a carrier of the fire of revival.
This
is why I'm praying for us. Today the Lord will open our eyes. The Lord will open our eyes. And we will understand his message to us in Jesus' name. This evening, we are talking about giving the more earnest heed to the truth.
If he is still giving the full otito,
giving the more earnest heed to the truth.
If he is still giving the full otito,
giving the more earnest heed to the truth.
If he is still giving the full otito,
the question is, what is truth?
Ibere beni wipe kini onti anpeni otito.
What is truth? Jesus is truth.
Jesus ni otito ni.
Anything that you can find in God the Father, you can see it in God the Son.
Onkon tabari ni Olorun Baba be la ori ni Jesus ti kala rae.
Jesus said, I am the way, the truth and the life.
Jesus wi pe emi ni ona otito ati iye.
No one can go to the Father except through me.
Eni kelo le to Baba bi ko se ni pase emi.
Meaning that except we follow the truth of Jesus.
Yes, we see that people should be atele otito ti Jesus
has spoken by Jesus.
Or ti aso ni pastor Jesus
has proclaimed by the apostles.
As it aso ni power apostle.
Except we follow them.
People should be atele won.
Except we obey them.
People should be agbo si won ni.
Except we put them into practice.
People should be agbo si oju ise.
Because it goes beyond hearing.
Nitori pe oju gbigbo ni kan lo.
It goes beyond coming to Bible study.
Oh, do you want to keep on Bible in the corner?
It goes beyond being a teacher, a Sunday school teacher, a children teacher. It goes beyond being a preacher.
Oh, you can my quote ko abikaje oluko belo.
But what God is expecting from us?
Shiba oh, so you are ready let your double boa.
As it is very sweet to preach.
Odu lati ma wasu.
As it is very sweet to explain.
What is your duty? Lati ma share alaye.
Also explain that passage of the scripture with our character.
Awon bi ti an so ni bibeli ki a ma shalaye re pelu awon ise wa.
Our life must be a living epistle of Christ.
Igbayo gbodo je episteli aye fun ti Christi.
That even though we did not preach the gospel, where we found ourselves, our character we preach. This is why this evening we are talking about giving the more earnest heed to the truth. And I said, what is the truth? Anything called truth, people call truth, and it is outside Christ. It is outside the doctrines of Christ, outside the doctrines of the apostle, that is the truth. Anything anybody preach,
and
we can't find it in the Bible. The Bible does not back it up. The Bible does not support it. Then why are we preaching such things? That means we are trying to write our own Bible. But to understand the truth,
but Latin
we must know who Jesus is. We must know the principle of Jesus. We must know the characters of Jesus. We need to study that. We study the character of Jesus. We have studied the lifestyle of Jesus. Then we compare that thing, compare the life of Jesus with the truth we said we are proclaiming. Then we will see that the teaching of Christ is against it. The doctrine of the apostles are against it.
àwọn ẹ̀kọ́ apostili ó lòdì sí.
Then we should know that that is not truth.
Káwa mọ̀ pé irú nǹkan bẹ́ẹ̀ kò kí ṣe òtítọ́.
So now that we have known the truth.
Báyìí tó ti mọ òtítọ́ ni.
We know who the truth is.
Àwọn ẹni tí ń ṣe òtítọ́ náà.
Jesus is the truth.
Jésù ni òtítọ́ yìí.
His doctrine is truth.
Ẹ̀kọ́ rẹ̀ òtítọ́ ni.
His teaching is truth.
Àwọn ẹ̀kọ́ àṣù rẹ̀ òtítọ́ ni.
The apostles follow his teaching.
Àwọn apostili wọ́n tẹ̀lé ẹ̀kọ́ rẹ̀.
They obey his teaching.
Wọ́n gbọ́ sí ẹ̀kọ́ rẹ̀.
Because they know it is the truth.
Wọ́n mọ̀ pé ó jẹ́ òtítọ́.
In fact, Jesus told them.
Kódà Jésù sọ fún wọn.
There are so many things I will have tell you now.
Ó ní ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ kan ló ń bẹ tí mo lè sọ fún yín báyìí.
I will not do that.
Bí màá bí mo sì gbọ́ mi ò ní lè ṣe bẹ́ẹ̀.
When I will send the Holy Spirit.
Ṣùgbọ́n tí n bá wá ẹ̀mí mímọ́ wá.
He will come and teach you the truth.
Àwa kọ yín ní àwọn òtítọ́ ni.
I will now see in the ministry of the apostles.
Àwa rí nínú àwọn iṣẹ́ ìránṣẹ́ wa apostili.
Truth the Holy Ghost open their eyes to.
Òtítọ́ tí ẹ̀mí mímọ́ ṣí ojú wọn sí.
This is why when we want to interpret the Bible.
Èrèdí ni tọ́ fẹ́ ṣe ìtumọ̀ Bíbélì.
If we want to exposit the Bible.
Fi àwọn fẹ́ fọ́ Bíbélì kalẹ̀.
We must understand something.
A gbúdọ̀ ní òye nkankan.
You must know that truth.
A gbúdọ̀ mọ òtítọ́ ni.
And you must allow the Holy Spirit to guide you.
A sì gbọ́dọ̀ gba ẹ̀mí mímọ́ láàyè kí ó máa darí wa.
It is our generation.
Ìgbà tí ẹ wà yìí gbọ́ngbọ́ngbọ́.
That they will be using dictionary to interpret the Bible.
Wọ́n máa lo àwọn ìwé kan láti máa fi ṣe ìtumọ̀ Bíbélì.
They will pick a verse of the Bible.
Wọ́n á mú abala kan nínú Bíbélì.
Without knowing the contents, the purpose of that statement.
Láì mọ èrèdí tàbí kọ ọ̀rọ̀ náà.
Then they will fly on.
Wọ́n máa sọ kiri.
And before you know it.
Yàtọ̀ wá mọ̀.
Their preaching.
Ẹ̀kọ́ wọn.
Will now start a this part of the scripture.
A gbọ́dọ̀ lò sí apá kan nínú ìwé mímọ́.
And people will be full of confusion.
Àwọn ènìyàn máa kú fún rududu.
But if we want to live by the truth.
Ṣùgbọ́n bàbá fẹ́ gbé nípasẹ̀ òtítọ́.
We must study the apostles' doctrine.
A gbúdọ̀ kọ́ ẹ̀kọ́ àwọn apostili.
What are the things that they practice?
Kí ni àwọn nǹkan tí wọ́n gbé sójú ìṣe?
What was their teaching?
Kí ni ẹ̀kọ́ wọn?
What was their standard?
Kí ni ìgbékalẹ̀ wọn?
Then we compare it with our own standard.
Kí ẹ wá gbé wò pẹ̀lú àwọn ìṣe títí wa bá.
Then we have to live by the standard of the apostles.
Wọ́n gbúdọ̀ wà pẹ̀lú ìgbékalẹ̀ àwọn apostili.
Because that is the standard the Lord revealed to them.
Wípé èyí ni ìgbékalẹ̀ tí Olúwa fi hàn wọ́n.
Which the Holy Ghost taught them.
Àti tí ẹ̀mí mímọ́ tí ó kọ́ wọn.
This is why the truth that we have heard.
Èyí ni òtítọ́ ni tí ó ti gbọ́.
The truth that we know.
Òtítọ́ náà tí a ti mọ̀.
You must keep it.
O gbúdọ̀ dì í mú ṣiṣẹ́.
You must guide it.
O gbúdọ̀ pa á mọ́.
So that you know Paul says something.
Paul
He said, I know if I leave.
Ó ní pé mo mọ̀ pé tí máa fi sílẹ̀.
There are preachers.
Àwọn olùkọ́ kan máa wá.
That are going to confess preachers.
Àwọn wọ́n máa wá dúdú ìdàkọ àwọn dúdú ìdàkọ yìí.
They will come in and crept in.
Wọ́n á rápálá wọlé.
And they will teach you first the truth.
Wọ́n máa kọ́ ní ẹ̀kọ́ èké.
Such will never happen to us in Jesus' name.
Ìṣẹ́ lórúkọ ti Jésù.
So we are talking about giving the more earnest heed to the truth.
À ń kọ́ nípa fífi etí sílẹ̀ gidigidi fún òtítọ́.
Now,
bayi,
the truth is the word of God.
Òtítọ́ ni ọ̀rọ̀ Ọlọ́run.
When we go to the New Testament,
ọ̀rọ̀ sí májẹ̀mú titun.
We see so many of the doctrine of Christ.
A rí ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ ẹ̀kọ́ Jésù Kristì níbẹ̀.
That is the truth.
Èyí gbogbogbogbo ni òtítọ́ ni.
The truth inspired by the Holy Ghost.
Òtítọ́ èyí tí ẹ̀mí mímọ́ tí omi sí.
Revealed by the Holy Ghost.
Èyí tí ẹ̀mí mímọ́ tí ó fi hàn.
And now,
bayi,
when we have the truth.
Tí a bá wá ní òtítọ́ ni.
The Lord is not telling us.
Olúwa wa sọ fún wa wípé.
You must keep it.
O gbúdọ̀ pa á mọ́.
With earnest.
O gbúdọ̀ pa á mọ́ gidigidi.
It means you keep it with all your strength and power.
Yẹ ni pé wàá pa mọ́ pẹ̀lú gbogbo okun àti agbára rẹ.
You have been in Christ 50 years does not mean that you cannot be misled.
O ti wà ní inú Kristi fún ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ ọdún kò túmọ̀ sí pé a ò ní ṣe ọ̀darí.
This is why the Bible say give more earnest heed.
Èrí ni Bíbélì pé kí a máa fetí sílẹ̀ gidigidi.
In the book of Hebrews chapter 3 verse 1.
Nínú Ẹgbẹ́rù orí ìkẹta ẹsẹ̀ kìíní.
Hebrews chapter 3 verse 1.
Ìwé Ẹgbẹ́rù orí ìkẹta ẹsẹ̀ kìíní.
Let's see what the word of God said there.
Ká gbọ́ ohun tí ọ̀rọ̀ náà ń sọ ní ibẹ̀ yẹn.
Hebrews chapter 3 verse 1.
Ìwé Ẹgbẹ́rù orí ìkẹta ẹsẹ̀ kìíní.
The Bible says something there.
Bíbélì sọ kankan níbẹ̀.
He said, wherefore, holy brethren, partakers of the heavenly calling, consider the apostles and high priests of our profession, Christ Jesus.
Nítorí náà, ẹ̀yin ará mímọ́, alábàápín ìpè ọ̀run, ẹgbà tí apostili àti olórí àlùfáà ìjẹ́wọ́ wa rò, àní Jésù.
He said, consider.
Peter the apostle and high priest of our profession, Christ Jesus. What does that mean? Now he said, consider, look at the profession of Jesus Christ. Look at our high priest. Look at his lifestyle when he was on earth. Look at his profession among men. Everywhere he goes, he do good. Everywhere he goes, he preach the truth. Everywhere he goes, he want people to take heed of their sin. And now the Bible says, he said, holy brethren, but are you holy brethren? Partakers of the heavenly calling. Are you a partakers of the heavenly calling? You know what it means? What is the heavenly calling? God is calling everybody to fellowship with him. If you are not in fellowship with God, if you are not in fellowship with God, if you don't live as God has required, just imagine, heaven has his standard, and it is by that standard that we can get there. So if anybody just come and bring and said, this is what you have to do, this is what you have to do, and we can't see that in the Bible, it will not take you to anywhere. But he said, partakers of the heavenly calling. Do you know what that place means? We are partakers of that standard. Of that doctrine, we have known the calling, the call of God to humanity, to repent of their sin, to turn away from their evil, to live soberly, to live righteously, to live a life of total consecration. And this is what the Bible says, partakers of the heavenly calling. I pray you will be among them. He said, now you are holy brethren. Let's say you said you are holy brethren, and you say you are partakers of the heavenly calling. He's now saying, don't forget our apostle and high priest of our profession,
apostle
Christ Jesus.
Olori alufa Jesu Oluwa.
Any heavenly calling you profess, any standard or doctrine you profess, we stand against the rules that our high priest has showed us. Then you have to know that it is not the truth of the word of God. It is my prayer for us. The Lord will help us, and we shall take earnest heed to the truth in the name of Jesus. I thought your amen will be louder. Let your amen carry fire. I want only the sister to say
amen.
And only the brother now. We need to understand. It is not only by saying amen. It goes beyond saying amen. But what the Lord is expecting from us, He said, let us. He said, consider the heavenly calling. And consider the apostle and high priest of our profession. Examine it. Compare your profession with his profession. Then examine yourself. If they stand against each other, or they are in line with each other, but it is my prayer, the Lord will help us in the name of God. So if there is anything we need to understand, that is taking heed unto the truth that we have heard. And if there is anything that is breaking the heart of Jesus,
it's
for a brother or a sister who knows the truth. He knows that truth. He now allowed the truth to sleep. He allowed the truth to sleep because he has found an heresy that sounds as the truth, that look like the truth.
Okay?
He now rejected and fight the real truth of Christ. Which is the word of God. This always brings the heart of God. That man, that brother, that a sister, who are once a proclaimer of the truth, who are once a proclaimer of the truth of God, the sons of the truth of God,
has
come across some certain preacher who are telling him that he is going too far, who are telling him that he has not done anything. And before you know it, they begin to introduce the first doctrine, and before you know it,
they
now begin to tell people, you know, that thing I said that time, don't mind me. I didn't know the truth that time. But now I have found the truth. That is not truth. Now let's share the book of Hebrews chapter 2 verse 1. Hebrews chapter 2 verse 1. I hope you are there. We want to read it together. Have you opened your Bible? Hebrews chapter 2 verse 1.
He
said, therefore, we ought to give the more earnest heed to the things
which
we have had, lest at any time we should let them slip. This is what the word of God said that.
Dear,
it said we must take earnest heed to what we have had. To what we have had. What is the things that we had? The word of God. The sermon. The teaching. The exhortation. The encouragement. The rebuke. The discipline. The corrections. The counsel. And all other truths that we have told us. He said we should give more earnest heed so that they will not slip away. One thing you need to understand, what we teach you here is the truth. By the grace of God, if you live by it, if you obey it, if you obey the word of God, if you allow it to guide and direct you, you will see that at the end of the day, you will make it to heaven in Jesus' name. The fact you need to understand about the church, the truth that saves soul, it is not a man-made truth. It is not what you just imagine. I say God wants us to be doing this. And God did not say that. And you say that anyone that disobeys, such a person is going to hell.
Or
else the Bible has not said such things. Whatever God says,
will
trace and found it in the Bible. Do you understand? Whatever that comes from the mouth of God, if you will trust it, you will see a portion of the Bible that back it up. What am I trying to say? One thing you need to understand about Bible.
Oh, to put a Bible.
It contains all the answers of life.
Oh, kufun gbogbo idahun aye yi.
It contains all the answer to the question bothering your mind.
Oh, kufun gbogbo idahun fun ibere so don buru ni okan re.
There is nothing bothering the heart of man under the sun.
Ko si won to ru ni okan eniyan ni abe orun yi.
That you cannot find answer to it in the Bible.
Ti o le ri idahun si ni Bible.
No, so study my Bible.
Bi mo se kan Bible mi.
And I go to a place.
Mo de mi kan pato.
And I read that particular portion.
O wa ka bi ibi na.
And the Spirit of God spoke to me.
Emi lo wa ba mi soro.
And said, now, what do you think about this place?
Pe bayi, kini ohun ti kini o mo nipa bi bayi?
It's like, you know, somebody just open enlighten me.
Isiru da pe enikan wa si mi ni oye boro.
And do you know what?
Ya mo nkan to sele.
I said, now I have understand.
Won pe bayi o ti ye mi.
That the Bible,
get the belly.
Contain
okun fun
answer to the questions of life.
Idahun fun gbogbo ibere aye yi.
Look at those things.
Sika wo.
Let me tell you something.
Sokoko fun wa.
If somebody maltreat you,
be any con ba fi aje yi,
you don't need to pray against the person.
O lati fi gbadura lori se niyan.
Do you understand?
Ijoye wa.
Somebody maltreat you,
any con fi aje o.
Somebody, you know, lied against you,
paro lori si e.
Somebody said all manner of things about you,
o so ni ru lori si e.
Somebody is trying to, you know, to hurt you,
any con fe pa lara.
You don't need to tell the person to die.
O ni la so funke eni pe poku.
The God have already stated what will happen to the person.
Oluwa ti so ohun ti o sele gan si eniyan.
The Bible says,
Bible wi pe,
he that reward evil for good,
eni to ba fi rere so buburu,
said evil shall not depart from his house.
Pe eni to ba fi buburu so ire, buburu ko ni ko ni ile re.
Do you understand what I mean?
Njo ye wa.
That is what the Bible say.
Ohun ti Bible say niyan.
Means that when you do good unto somebody,
you be to ba se rere se nikan,
and the person reward you with evil,
anyone fi ibis ibis lo pada
po, you don't need to pray that, hey, oh God, ah, look at what this person do to me, hey, smart him with thunder, hey, dude, you don't need to do that. The God have already spoken. It may be 2 years, 3 years, 4 years, the word of God will surely come to pass.
Yeni pe beni koma fi ibu ibu rusto ire fuwa a lati ma gbadun lo se ni pe ki ara popa ni yeni pe olorun ti so ohun to ma se se ni sile pe elu ba fi buburu so ire ibi koni koni ile re.
So the truth,
otito ti an so yi,
that save souls,
si o ma n gba okola,
that save life,
si o n gba aye eniyan la,
it is not a man-made truth.
So ki n se otito ti atowode eniyan,
it is not a popcorn that we can just pick.
Ko ki n se nkan papanu ta ko le mu.
It is not, you know, a pebbles that we can just pick at the seashore.
O te n se nkan ta ko le mu bi abi iyepe kan ni eti okun.
But it is rather obtained as gold and silver.
Ṣugbọn a ni lati mu gẹgẹ bi wura.
You dig and dig and dig and dig deeper.
Why wale jile jile ni paro no?
And when you search the truth,
see, oba shewari otito yi,
you look for the truth.
Why wa otito yi ri?
With diligence,
pelu ifiyesi,
and you got it.
Wa gbamu.
You will keep it jealously.
Wa pamo gidi gidi.
Let's share the book of Proverbs chapter 2, verse 3 to 5.
Kawe iwe owe ori keji.
Proverbs chapter 2 verse 3 to 5.
Obe ori keji ese keta ti dide ese karun.
The Bible says,
Bible wipe
3 to 5, the Bible says,
Bible wipe ni ese keta si karun.
Let not mercy and truth. Let not mercy and truth do what? I can't hear us. Now let I want to wait for us. Let's open our Bible.
Be ki ashi Bible wa bayi.
Proverbs chapter 3.
Iwewe ori keta
3 to 5.
Ese keta di ese karun.
Let not mercy and truth do what?
Ma se je ki anu ati otito se kini?
Don't let them forsake you.
Ma se je ki o ko sile.
He now says,
won wi pe,
he said, bind them about thy neck.
So won mo orun re
as when you put a chain on the neck of the devil.
Because
on the neck of dog, your brother.
See, Oba fi shake shake abi awon si on waja.
It's there.
O wa nibe o.
And you tie it down.
O wa so mole.
It must always be there.
O puro wa nibe.
He say, write them.
O ni pe so won mo
upon the table of thy heart.
So won si wala aya re.
That is how we should treat the truth.
Bí o ṣe ka mú ti tọ́ nìyí.
We should write them that they should always be in our heart.
Kán wà ní tábìlì ọkàn wa.
They should always be like ornament on our neck.
Ó dàbí wúrà ní ọrùn wa.
So shall thou find favor.
Benny, you are already ojurere.
And good understanding.
Ati honorere.
In the sight of God.
Loji olorun.
Ama.
Ati eniyan.
Do you know?
Jamo.
That even in this end time.
Be anini beke yi.
People are looking for men of truth.
Awon eniyan wa awon eniyan otito.
Have you studied that?
She ele she shati chawari
re bi. People are looking for men of truth.
Won wa awon eniyan otito.
If they want to give you a big contract.
Won fun ni ise nla kan.
And they want to give you money.
Won fun ni owo.
He say,
"My
brother, can I trust you?
She ali bekele o.
I know you are a Christian,
no? You're a Christian,
but can I trust you?
You ali bekele o bi?
In this end time, even in our society,
anini awujawa,
they are looking for men of truth.
Wa awo eni yosita.
I'm not talking of people with a depraved mind.
Yo, sonny, but I want you to come up here.
That their conscience are dead.
Ti eri o kwa ti joku.
Those who have raised up a preacher for themselves.
I want you to be only one to call the phone around.
So tell them what pleases them.
Love is so what you want for.
But I'm talking about generally in our society.
Wa mo sonny, but gbogbo ni awujawa.
People are looking for men of truth.
And when you want, and when you all
know, because they know that men of truth cannot deceive.
Oh my God, what you want so? What you want all the money?
The Bible says, "The
believing man,
so shall thou find favor and good understanding in the sight of God and a man."
Ben, what you are doing? What you are doing? As it is, what you are doing?
You will be favored when you always speak the truth.
Baba, so that when you are doing,
when you are a man of truth, God will favor you.
Be about genuine. Don't so that all what you are doing, you are doing,
and you will even find favor in the sight of God.
Why not you imagine your Lord?
Even when it is hard to say it, say it.
I didn't think that somebody like so. So
even when it is not convenient for the hearer, say it.
No, but then what you want to go alone? Yes, you want to be like this.
Say the truth and let your mind be free.
So talk to your core.
Because
free.
Whenever the Lord tells you to speak the truth,
you never people so you call back.
And you are afraid you did not say it.
So one day over so
if you're a true child of God, God will not give you rest.
Oh, you are going for this in your
until you have told that truth.
As somebody started to you.
Now verse 5.
Why is it carry on?
He said, trust in the Lord with all thy heart and lean not unto thy own understanding.
Di gbogbo aya re gbekele Oluwa, ma si se te si imo ara re.
Don't say I have already known the truth.
Mo wi pe mo ti mo ti to yi na.
Don't say what they are. They teach us in our church. So I believe that anything outside the church that they don't, I heard in another church, in another ministry, I don't need to obey them.
Ma so pe ohun ti mo o di ko wa ni o ti to ni ile ijo si wa. Nigba na ohun to ba ko wa ni ijo mi abi se ose mi ran mi o ni lati gboro si
won. You must understand that any church. Any church funded by Christ, it is the body of Christ. Therefore, any truth that comes from any ministry or any church, we are to obey them because they come from God.
Nítorí náà, ọ̀rọ̀ títún tó bá wá láti ìṣèlọ́sẹ̀ kan àbí ìjọ kan, a gbúdọ̀ bọ́ sílẹ̀ nítorí pé ọwọ́ fúnra rẹ̀ gan ni ó sọ.
We don't say we don't believe that in our church.
A ò gbọ́ sọ pé a ò gbọ́ lè gbọ́ nílé ìjọsìn wa.
We don't believe that in our ministry.
A ò gbọ́ nílé ìṣèlọ́sẹ̀ wa.
Any truth,
òtítọ́,
that can be found in Bible, in the Bible.
Tí a lè rí nínú Bíbélì.
We are to do what?
A gbúdọ̀ ṣe kíni.
We are to do what?
A gbúdọ̀ ṣe kíni.
We are to obey them.
A gbúdọ̀ gbọ́ràn.
So what am I trying to say?
Kini ti mo fe lati so?
If we want to live by the truth,
bi aba be bi nipa se otito,
and if we want to grow in the truth,
as te bi gba ninu otito,
we have to use all our energy.
A gbudo lo gbogbo okun wa.
We need much prayer.
A nilo agbara ti o po.
Self examination.
Ati iyare diwo.
And self denial.
Ati ise ara eni.
If we will grow in the knowledge of the truth,
bi aba be dagba ninu otito,
and if we will obey the truth,
bi aba be
those who are living by the truth,
and what you want to
it, they found it, they look for it, they search it earnestly and diligently. And they diligently listen to what God is speaking to them in their soul. Because the moment you have come to a junction whereby you say, Lord, I surrender all, I am ready to hear the truth, I will obey the truth. Anything you tell me to do, I will do it. And God see that truly you are willing to hear and to obey, to live by it, then God will begin to speak to you.
Nígbà tó bá sọ pé Olúwa mo ṣetán láti gbọ́ òtítọ́ yìí láti farabalẹ̀ gbọ́ láti gbọ́ràn sí lẹ́nu nígbà náà Olúwa máa fẹ́ láti máa bá ọ sọ̀rọ̀.
And now when the Lord has not spoken to you.
Báyìí tí Olúwa bá ti wá bá ọ sọ̀rọ̀.
You know I remember that time.
Mo rántí nígbà náà.
Something was bothering my mind.
Nǹkan ń rún ní ọkàn mi.
It was really bothering my mind about issue of women dressing.
Ó ń rún lọ́kàn mi nípasẹ̀ ìmúra àwọn obìnrin.
And one day,
I
now heard a revelation. And the Lord began to explain to me how women ought to dress. This is why no matter heresies anybody bring up, it can never change my mind on what God has revealed to me. But if I did not bother, I did not care. I just keep quiet. And I keep on teaching on normal things without shaking into the word of God, without looking into the word of God. Even the Bible, my own interpretation, without allowing the author of the Bible to come and explain, you will be deceived. And before you know it, when you are deceived, you deceive others. That's how it always works. When you are deceived, you will deceive others. Then you are second hand false prophet. But when you have got the truth, when somebody now come up and say what stand against what God have told you, and when God told you that time, you have strong conviction. You have strong conviction. It is, I have come across people, I know people that, you know, they have been in Christ for so many years, and even some are even men of God, but when they come across heresies, it will change their mind. It will change their mind. So it is not how old you are in Christ. The Bible says, take more earnest heed.
Shora gidigidi.
I pray you will take heed. So when you have got the truth, what God is expecting from us, you are to wash. You are to keep it. You must not willingly fall into sin. You must not willingly pretend as if you have forgotten that truth. You must meditate on that truth of God day and night. Because getting saved, it's not taking a holiday outing. You must understand, to be saved, you must not rest.
Oh, Buddha, see me.
Paul did not rest.
Paul, look, see me.
Until he said, I have fought the good fight of faith.
Paul
said, this year, in my Christian race, I want to take a little outing holiday out of the narrow way to the wide way, just to enjoy little. The later I will now come back to Christ. The men and women who are full of truth, who are walking embodiment of the truth, they have not become so without effort. They put effort into it. Men that stand for truth, that the truth that God has revealed unto them, that are walking embodiment of truth. In their speech you see truth. In their dressing you see truth. In their character you see truth. In everything, in all aspects of their life, we see truth. They have not become so without effort. They have digged for the truth. They have loved it. They have longed for it more than their necessary food. And they have sacrificed all for it. All that I want, all that I need, all that I desire is only the truth of the word of God. I don't need any other thing.
No, thank you,
a man was praying for a revival in his country, and he went on his knees for 3 days, shedding tears, and said, Lord, revive this country.
Sorry, lady.
about this country.
Sorry, lady.
Give me a message.
For
me,
it was to come
that will turn this country upside down.
See, I hear lady call for
that's Jonathan Edwards.
Only Jonathan Edwards.
He keep on seeking the face of God.
Oh, wow, Jonathan Bubega.
On his knee.
Ni ori ekure.
Shedding tears.
Oh, sokun.
God.
Oluwa.
Give me a message.
For me, wasu.
That will revive this country.
That's sorry, lady.
He prayed and prayed and prayed.
Oh, badura, badura.
And when the Lord see.
But you know what?
His diligence.
Ori ifarabalere.
Commitment.
Ori ifaranije.
Consecration.
Iyara instotore.
And sacrifice.
Ati rubo.
For the truth.
For the toyi.
That will revive that nation.
Yeah, sorry, lady.
Do you know what the Lord spoke to him?
Olua sofumbi.
Write. Pick your pen.
Mu gegere.
And write.
Koko iwe.
Sinners.
Eleshe.
In the hand of angry God.
Ni owo Olorun ti o nbinu.
That message was given by the Holy Ghost.
Emi mo lo fun ni iwasu yi.
As the normal service.
Ni ile ijosin.
The hymn and all that.
Won korin se gbogbo e.
And the man got on the pulpit with the script.
Oni iwasu arakunrin o wa dori pepe pelu iwe ti o ko sile.
He got that sermon after many days.
Leyin opo ojo. Leyin ojo meta.
3 days.
Leyin ojo meta.
Because his heart was burning.
Nitori pe oko re o n gbona.
He was he discovered that no strategy can work.
O ri pe ko si ogbon mo ko re ikan to le wole.
Except the Holy Ghost work.
Afi bi emi mo ba sise nikan.
Start to cry.
Okay.
God,
Olorun,
give me a message.
Fun mi ni wasu.
That will revive this nation.
Ta sori le deji.
He was looking for the truth.
O mo titan.
As he got on the pulpit.
Bo se lori pepe.
Preaching that message.
O wasu eko na.
Sinner in the hands of angry God.
Eleshe lowo Olorun tin binu.
People stand to stand up.
O nbe sin dide.
Some went to the side of this of the church.
Eni kan lo si apa kan ile ijosin.
To the side of the pillar.
Si ibi opo ile.
What are they doing there?
Lo wa nibe.
They are shedding tears.
O sokun.
People were coming to the pulpit.
O nbe sin wa saju pepe.
That message today.
Wasu eko ni.
Is the most popular message in all over the world.
O ni iwasu eyi ti o to gbadugbada ju ni gbogbo agbaye.
Although the man is dead.
Looto oniwasu ti ku.
But the message is still reviving life.
Ṣùgbọ́n iwasu o si n sọ gbogbo aye eniyan yi.
Now tell me.
Wa sọ fun mi o.
The man that God gave him such a message.
Ẹni tí Ọlọ́run fún ni iwasu bẹ́ẹ̀.
He will not come up.
Wa wa.
And said.
O wa wipe.
All this judgment message.
Ṣé ẹnìkan wọ́n wẹ́ pé gbogbo ìwàásù ìdájọ́ tó ń sọ ń padà yìí.
All this hellfire.
Ọ̀rọ̀ àpáde tó ń wí yìí gan.
Our God is not that wicked like that.
Olúwa kò rorò tó bẹ́ẹ̀.
Please, if you have not read that book, go and read it. You will know what I'm talking about.
Lọ́ka wà á mọ̀ kan tí mo sọ nípa rẹ̀.
You will see God speaking.
Wà á rí bí Olúwa ti sọ̀rọ̀.
God speaking.
Olúwa bó ṣe
sọ̀rọ̀. Oh God. I've never seen a man preaching that way before.
Mi ò rí kí ènìyàn wá sùn bẹ́ẹ̀ rí.
I've read so many holiness end time, ancient holiness preacher, but that particular message is a different message.
Mo ti kàwé nípa àwọn akọni ìgbani tó wá sùn òbí wa mímọ́, ṣùgbọ́n eléyìí tá a sọ nípa rẹ̀ yìí ó yàtọ̀ gidigidi.
You will see that truly this message.
A rí pé nítorí ìwàásù yìí.
Is a message that come from the mouth of the Holy Ghost.
Ó ṣe èyí tó ti ẹnu ẹ̀mí mọ́ jáde wá.
The sinners.
Àwọn eléṣe.
The wicked men.
Àwọn ènìyàn ibi.
They are like they should take a stone and throw against him.
Wọ́n dàbí pé kọ́ mú òkúta kọ́ sọ́ọ̀lù.
The man looked verily to their direction.
Ọkùnrin yẹn wojú wọn kárakára.
And spoke more passionately.
Ó tún wọ́n sọ̀rọ̀ pẹ̀lú ìtara sí i.
And that message.
Ìwàásù náà.
Increase the church.
Ó tún wá mú kí ìjọkọ́.
Revive the church.
Ó ń sọ̀jọ́ jí.
He went far.
Ó jinlẹ̀.
Just in one location.
Ní ìpele kan.
Just as when we are doing Bible study.
Báyé ṣe bíbélì kíkọ níbẹ̀ báyìí.
And the message here.
Àti ìwàásù mi báyìí.
Just went far.
Ó wá rìn káàkiri.
People begin to carry the message up and down.
Wọ́n bẹ̀rẹ̀ sí ń gbé ìwàásù káàkiri.
Men begin to repent in the street.
Wọ́n bẹ̀rẹ̀ sí ronúpò nínú ẹ̀ṣẹ̀ wọn ní
àkókò náà. Have you heard this? Have you heard this?
Ìdíkọ̀lẹ̀ ti gbálẹ̀ yìí.
Oh God, the Lord will do that for us.
Olúwa yóò ṣe lè fún wa.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Lórúkọ Jésù.
So this man of God.
Ìránṣẹ́ Ọlọ́run yìí.
This man that are preachers of the truth.
Àwọn ìránṣẹ́ Ọlọ́run tó ń sọ òtítọ́ yìí.
They sacrifice all for it.
Wọ́n fi gbogbo rẹ̀ rúbọ fún un.
When they have fallen.
Nígbà tí wọ́n ṣubú.
They rise up again.
Wọ́n tún dìde.
When they are defeated.
Nígbà tí wọ́n ṣẹ́gun wọn.
They have no yielded to discouragement.
Wọ́n ò yẹ̀bá sí àìmọ́nilọ́kànlé.
Many of them has failed.
Ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ wọn ló ṣubú.
Many of them failed.
Ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ ṣubú.
But they were not discouraged.
Ṣùgbọ́n wọn kò ṣẹlẹ̀ máa mọ́kànlé.
They rise up.
Wọ́n tún dìde.
And said no.
Wọ́n pe rárá o.
This and this must happen.
Eléyìí gbúdọ̀ ṣẹlẹ̀.
I will continue to live. seek for the truth.
What the struggle in my world, you talk
until when I get it. So, but with more care and watchfulness,
pelu ishara ati nani
and greater earnestness,
ati kubeto ni abara,
they will renew their effort to attend to the truth.
What truth? What she lati ye bafu? In looking
for the truth,
we want to tell you.
The Bible says they are looking for a city whose building, whose builder and foundation is God.
Foundation.
They come across the sons of anarchy. They come across pharaohs and you know the Egyptians' army and all that the Red Sea. But yet, they were looking for a country which God told them about.
See, all of stuff
and now Jesus said, I'm going to prepare a place for you. And wait, we are looking for that city.
We want to
see the reality of that place. Until the Lord say, welcome my faithful servant.
We
will get there. These people, they have not counted. They have counted not their life dear unto themselves that they might know the truth. All manners of wealth is a name among men, reputations, pleasures, and everything that the world holds has been counted as dung and dross in the pursuit of truth. They want to get that truth. And everything that will distract them, they take it aside. I don't need this. Go away. A good name among men. Reputations. Everything that the world holds. God, give me the truth. Tell me the truth. Or I die.
Abi,
that is their constant prayer. That is their constant prayer. Lord, I will obey. I will follow. Tell me the truth. Show me the path of truth. If you do not tell me, I will not live. If you do not open my eyes to that truth that saves, to that truth that transforms, I will not live. And some, they wait 3 days, 2 days, until the Lord speak to them.
He
says, son, this and this and this is the truth. And they found that perfect truth. The truth that saves, that satisfies the heart, that answers the questions of life, that bring fellowship with God and bring perfect peace. The real truth always bring peace. When you obey it, it gives you peace. When you follow it gives you peace. This is why, as it costs, as it gets, you know, it costs effort to find the truth. So it requires washing to keep it. Riches have wings. They can fly away if they are not guided. Likewise, truth have wings. They can fly away if you don't earnestly and jealously and watchfully keep them. The Bible says in the book of Proverbs chapter 23 verse 3. Proverbs 23. Bible says, buy the truth and do what?
Yes, shekini.
I can't hear you.
Yes, shekini.
Buy the truth and sell it not.
Yo, ma si sheta.
Also, wisdom.
Odo, pelu.
And instruction.
Ati eko.
And understanding.
Ati imoye.
When you get it, don't sell it. It means don't let it slip away because of any sin, because of any pleasure. But truth usually slip away little by little. It is lost as a leaking water is lost.
Oh man, son, me bati omi ban yolo.
To me banjo, dear. so it will not fall away all at once.
Ko ni danu be lojiji,
but little by little.
Ṣugbọn a mo ma jo die die.
This area
apako yi,
you overlook it. That area, you overlook it. Went on and on like that. Went on and on like that. Went on and on like that. You overlook this area. It doesn't, don't take more serious in that one. And before you know it, at last,
you
fall fatally. You will not fall. What are the examples of people that fell away from the truth? There are some people that they once pour out their money. They spend their money.
What is not over?
They normally spend their money for the poor and for the spread of the gospel. They were not afraid of the truth of God. They always supply all that the Lord wants. They were full of truth that all fear in their heart fade away. They were certain that if they seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, other things shall be added unto them. They did not fear that God will forget them, or God will leave them or forsake them, or leave his children to beg for food. They serve God gladly with all their hearts, and it doesn't care if they even sleep without eating. But little by little, the devil providence got into their hearts, and little by little, he let the truth of God's faithfulness and fatherly love, that God is a father that provide for the needs of his children, and they allow that truth to slip away, and now they are very stingy and anxious about tomorrow. But this is not how they started. They started well, providing for the poor, but along the way, the devil wiped away their eyes and set their eyes on the things of this world. You said you want to help the work of God. You said you want to help the overhead. Look at this one. Look at the roof of your house. Look at that one. Look at that one. Are you going to leave it? Now, if you share this money now, if you share this thing now, you take this one, you take that one, how much will be remaining? How much? Don't forget all those things. And from the beginning, it was not so. There's another set of people. They love to pray. Prayer was the breath of their life. But little by little, they allow the truth of the word of God to sleep. They said men ought always to pray and not to faint. And now their prayer life is cold and dead. But in the beginning, they rise up by themselves without setting any alarm to wake them up. And they will pray to God. They will pray with all their hearts. But now along the way, they allow the truth to slip. Because things are going well. There are two things that always happen to man. When things are going well, 99% of people normally forget God. And when things are going wrong, 95% of people normally forget God. But this set of people, it's like, what else am I going to pray about? What else? The church of God is there. The people is there.
The backsliders are there.
Awolese pe dan be
nibe. Family are there.
Ebi re nbe nibe.
Your ministry is there.
Ise ise re nbe nibe.
Your church is there.
Ijo re nbe nibe.
Your pastor is there.
Olusegun tere nbe nibe.
The word is there.
Aye pelu o nbe nibe.
That you need to pray for.
To lati gbadura fun.
The saint is there.
Awon yo fe nbe nibe.
The work of God.
Ise Olorun bako
na. The missionaries in the jungles.
Awon ajire ni papa.
In the villages.
Ni awon abule.
They are there that need prayer.
Won nbe ti won ni adura
re. But now.
Sugbon bayi.
He does not have anything that trouble him.
Ko wa
He is not moved, even though he had the bad news about missionaries in the jungle.
About a boy ni pa irin buburi pa wa ara awon ajire ni papa ko te ki mi ko mi lara mo.
So far everything is going well with him.
Mo le pe ohun gbo o nlo dede ni pa fun.
He does not pray always again.
Mo gbadura dede mo o.
I pray if you are cold in your prayer life, the Lord will revive you.
Olua yo so waji.
There are another set of people.
Awon eniyan mi.
These people, they always look for services.
Woman wa.
They always look for prayer meeting.
Mo wa si ike ipade adura.
Where they are doing programs.
Oh, ibi to ma n se pade.
People, they love going to programs.
Oh, ma fe lati ma lo si ipade.
They love attending programs.
Won ma fe lati ma lo si ipade.
And this set of people,
awon eniyan won yi,
before you know it,
se to mo ko to sele.
Little by little,
ni die die,
their portion, their position in the church become empty.
Ipo won ninu ile ijosin o wa di asan.
That particular place the normally sit became empty.
Ibi ton do ko si yen o wa di ibi ton sofo.
What happened?
Ilo wa sele.
When you call,
to ba pe won,
he said we didn't see you.
A ri yin.
See those children here.
Oh, awon mo yen.
Those children when they start like this.
O ma bere bayi.
And from the beginning still like that.
Ni bere ko si ri be.
Well, we don't see you.
A o ri e.
You need to understand, before I do this one, work in the kitchen, work in that place, I will be very tired, and time will be gone, and if I said I should, that's why I did not make it. Why? They allow the truth of the word of God.
That
say that we should not forsake the assemblies of brethren. They forsake and they allow that truth to sleep. They prefer to sleep at home than to come to
vigil.
They prefer to watch all those useless films than to come to Bible study.
They
prefer to go and watch football than to come to service.
It's
because they are carnal Christians.
Backsliders.
And they have allowed the church to sleep. Another set of people. This set of people. Before. You always see them. In the fellowship, but now they prefer to go to a clubhouse. They prefer to go to the beach. To go for excursion. To go to all these animal, where they put animals. So they love going there. Love going to zoo. We don't see you. I just said I should go and just refresh my memory. I just want to feel happy.
Another
set of people. This set of people. Normally make use of every opportunity to testify to the goodness of the gospel. Little opportunity they will preach the gospel. They will preach the gospel. But now they allow the truth to sleep. And before you know it, they begin to go into foolish talking and jesting, which are not convenient. They don't flow again. When they want to preach the gospel, they don't flow. But when they talk about politics, football match, season film, they will flow. They will narrate the story from A to Z. But explain John 3:16. You'll be scratching head. But from the beginning it's not like that. They
are
forgotten the truth. I pray you will not allow the truth to sleep.
Write
in the book of Ephesians chapter 5 verse 4.
Ephesians chapter 5 verse 4.
Efesi ori karun ese kerin.
Ephesians chapter 5 verse 4.
Efesi ori karun ese kerin.
This set of people
who
now go into jesting,
did
not forget the solemn word of Jesus Christ,
that
every idle man that God, that men speak, shall give account of it on the day of judgment. They no longer remember the portion of the Bible that says life and death are in the power of the tongue. But this set of people, they go more and more into jesting, and their tongue is not seasoned with grace and salt. And now he can talk anyhow on any matter. He can talk anyhow on any subject. At times, when he is joking, even use hair to joke.
Oh, my fi ori chefe.
So rapadi, I want to call our ambe. Oh, my jo ambe noni.
Oh, my rapadi shere chefe.
Justin.
Oh, my chefe.
I be speaking all those horrible things.
Man, someone already baje.
And that subject that normally peace is had before.
Oh, rotu ebe o man gunoko tele.
The subject of hell.
Oh, rapadi.
Of the kingdom of God.
Ti gbalo ru.
Of the rapture.
Ti ba soke.
Of the great tribulation.
Ti kunju lani.
That always is hard. That always make him to be touchful. That testimony that always tear up his heart. That always bring a terrible warning to the scarlet sinners. That word of God that always encourage the fainting and timid heart. That always bring shares and strength to the soldiers and saints. Now they now begin to jazz with all this. Like somebody, a musician.
Be olori kan.
I think her name is maybe Saint Janet, something like that.
Oya oruko ni Saint Janet.
I heard that, you know, she was singing the gospel before.
Mo gbo pe o ma n ko orin ire tele ri.
And people are not buying it.
Awon ni won ara.
And do you know what?
Nkan to sele.
She now begin to, oh God, will be using Christian song.
I'm only Christian
to be singing bad things.
I'm a only the bad.
You can't even hear it. It deadened the heart.
Oh man, power coin.
It corrupt the heart.
Oh man, di baje oko.
But from the beginning, those things touch her.
I won't come with you. Oh man,
those things cheer her up.
Oh man, who are okay?
But because of money, because of fame, and popularity, she now make jest of things that provoke God.
I won't come to Molon Bino Open Chef.
Make jest of things that provoke God to anger.
Oh, Mon, come to Molon Bino Open Chef.
She does not care about that.
Oh, none of them.
Another one,
come here.
They believe with their all heart.
These
are the set of women.
They
believe with all their heart that women that are professing godliness,
they
adorn themselves in modest apparel and in shamefacedness and sobriety. They must, they are dressing must be in line with the scripture. We know them when they dress. They dress godly as a woman after God's heart. But little by little, they allow the truth of the word of God to sleep. They now listen to the smooth temptation and whispering of the tempter. And they now fell as if into the hands of devil. When she ate the forbidden fruit. Now instead of modest apparel. Instead of modest apparel,
they will
deck themselves with gold. And they have lost the ornament of meek and quiet spirit. Which in the sight of God is a great price. They now paint, put on satanic high heel shoes.
Satan is yoga.
I have told you this before.
Mo so le fa tele ri.
Human beings are troubling themselves.
Awon eniyan lo nyora won lenu.
You will put on a shoe.
Omo wo bata.
That if care is not taken, you can fall.
E to ba shora gan o ma shubu.
And when you are walking,
bo wa rin.
You have to be very and extra careful.
O ni lati ma shora gidi gidi.
And when you remove the shoe,
to wa yo bata yi.
All your leg will now be paining you.
Bo gbese la ma ma dun o ru e.
Is that pleasure?
Se adun lele ibi?
Eh? Is it pleasure?
Se adun ni e.
That's not pleasure.
In se adun.
No, it's not pleasure.
In se afẹ kan.
And now,
bye.
You will now be walking like a cow.
Mo ma wa rin bi malu.
Telling God you should have created me as cow.
Ya Oluwa, o ba ti da mi ni malu.
That's what they are saying.
Ini ko ti won so nipa
re. Put on highly shoe.
Awon wa bata giga.
You know, when you shake the ankle, the leg of a cow.
Ba wo ese malu.
One side of it is a little bit up.
Ibi kan na pe oga.
So that high heel shoes made them to walk like a cow.
And they are
telling their creator,
you
should have created me as that animal.
Oh, but it may be malu yi.
So all those high heel shoes,
that
when husband and wife now stand beside
their,
the husband will now be very tall.
Oh yeah, okay.
The wife.
Yeah, our God, gogoro.
I'll be looking up. We'll be looking at the wife at the top.
Yeah, okay. Mama, would you? Are you okay?
Those things, you are just troubling yourself.
Okay, why? Wahala ni.
I can't dress moderately, as the Bible have said.
Mura, Bible is study party.
There are good shoes you can wear that are not high heel.
I want bata to the rawa ti won ko nse giga
to buru. Very good one that you can put on.
Itole wo sesere.
Good sandal that you can wear that is not high heel.
Si o da si o le wo ti ko nse giga.
But now you will now be walking as someone that have a boil at the bum bum.
Wonrin bi eni ti ewo muni di.
So you, it all those things is not fun.
Awon kan yi ko kin se afe.
The Bible said we should be moderate.
Philippe ka ma wa ka wa ni iwontunwonsi.
So when you are putting on such things, who are you imitating?
Ti o ba nwo wo kokon awon kan won yi, ta lo se to le se afara we.
In the early time, the prostitute are the one that normally put on such things.
Ni bere pepe awon asewo lo ma nwo won imura be yen.
Even in the beginning,
ani ni bere pepe.
The prostitute, they used to use something to cover their face.
O ma awon asewo ma fi kan boju won.
Like, I will not mention their name. Those people that used to put on black, you understand those people I'm talking about. They used to put on black from the head to the top. Those women, you understand what I'm talking about? Those people, you know their name. In the early time, it is the prostitute. They are the one that used harlot. They are the one that used to put on such clothes. But as they begin to civilize, they start to remove it little by little.
Oh, senior, dear, dear.
They will remove the one that covered the face.
It's so boji on your crew.
Before you know it, they can put on ordinary singlet. Before you know it, they can put on a very, very short skirt.
One skirt,
but with a very high heel shoe. And now, when a believer is doing the same thing,
ti oni gbagba ba nse bakan na,
who are we imitating?
Ti talin gan la nse aparawe.
For illustration,
fun apere,
you stand at the bus stop.
Odo ni beto ti ma wo moto.
The junction of the prostitute.
Awon ekori tawon asewo.
With your high heel shoe.
Oni pataki ga re.
And the prostitute also put on the high heel shoe.
Be alagbere pa asaga asewo yi, ohun na wo pataki ga.
And thank God you are beautiful than the harlot.
Ah, adupe pe iwo o si roba ju alagbere yi lo.
And you put on the high heel shoe.
Iwo o wa wo pataki ga yi.
And your clothes, the same clothes.
Aso kan na gan le wa jowo.
The same bad clothes.
Ah, shabu buru kono.
And those people, are you carry Bible?
You want
carry
Bible? You
carry Bible. That's the difference.
Yeah,
she carry purse or bag.
Oh, yeah, I show you. Oh, be baggy. I be purse.
But do you carry small Bible?
She more be Bible.
That purse Bible women normally carry.
Yeah, Bible. Tom, we must have a
man. That fashion Bible.
Fashion Bible. Tom, that
be purse. So both of you stand at the bus stop.
Emish, you want to see?
Those men that are not picking prostitutes,
they
not come to that junction.
Oh, the corita yen.
You want to enter vehicle going to your house.
Oh, the fellow want to see ilere.
But you are more beautiful than the harlot.
Oh, see re waju alagbere yen lo.
Who do you think that man will pick?
So for me, ta le lo pe okun yen o ma mu.
Eh?
Tani.
It is that Christian.
Christian yen lo ma mu.
Because there is no difference. The same clothes.
Asokono.
The same shoe.
Batakono.
And the same eyelash. Or what do you call it?
Ati konju ikwepe.
What do you call it?
Kono.
Eyelashes.
Ikon oju gbogbo.
And all those paint.
Gbogbo won da yen.
There is no difference.
Kosi yato.
So it is you.
You are gone.
The man say, you know, and when the pastor now said, hi, he was thank you. It is this one I want. We will point you to that Christian because there is no difference. So the Bible says, he said we should come out. So in any form should we resemble the unbeliever? So such people, what should they do? You must remember where they are falling and return to their first love. But those who still have the truth, how can we keep the truth? How should we take heed? Number one, you must take heed to the word of David to his son Solomon. You must take it to the word of David to his son Solomon.
Solomon.
In the book of 1 Chronicles 28 verse 8. Let's read it.
1 Chronicles 28 verse 8.
The Bible says something there. Bible says, now therefore, in the sight of all the creation of the Lord, and in the audience of our God, keep and seek for all the commandments of the Lord, your God, that ye may possess this good land and leave it for inheritance to your children after you forever.
Ori keji dini ogbose kejo wipe nje disisin ni oju gbogbo Israel ijo eniyan oluwa ati ni eti olorun wa e ma pamo ki esi ma saferi gbogbo ofin oluwa olorun yin ki ele ni ile ki le ni ile rere yi ki esi le fi sile ni ogun fun awon omo yin leyin yin lai lai.
Bible say keep and seek.
Nbe pamo ko si ma saferi re.
Keep and seek.
Pamo ko si saferi re.
What does that keep mean?
Kini tumo ka pa nkan mo yi?
The one you already know.
Oro ni ti o ti mo.
The commandment you already know.
Awon ase ti o ti mo.
Keep it.
Pamo.
Then seek.
Nigba na saferi re.
At least desire to grow more.
Pe gbongbe lati dagba si.
In the knowledge of God.
Ninu ogbon oro Olorun.
So that you may be able to teach your children. Number two, do what God commanded Joshua. In Joshua chapter 1 verse 8. Let's see what the word of God said in Joshua chapter 1 verse 8. The Bible says, this book of law shall not depart out of thy mouth, but thou shalt meditate therein day and night, that thou mayest observe to do according to all that is written therein. For then thou shalt make thy way prosperous, and then thou shalt have good success.
Iwe opin yi ko gboro kuro ni enu re, ṣugbọn iwo ma ṣe asaro ninu re ni ọsan ti ni oru ki iwo ki o le kiyesi ati ṣe gẹgẹ bi gbogbo eyi ti a ko sinu re. Nitori nigba na ni iwo o se ona re ni rere nigba na ni yo si dara fun o.
Meditate on that truth you have no day and night.
Nitori ti mo yi se ma sese lori e ni osun ati ni ori.
By doing that you will not allow the truth to sleep.
Nipa ki se be o ni otito yi ko bo lowo re.
Number 3,
eleketa,
quench not the spirit.
Ma se pa emi lenu mo.
Quench not the spirit.
Ma se pa emi lenu mo.
Jesus called the Holy Spirit the Spirit of Truth. And if you do not wish to sleep the truth, we must welcome the Spirit of Truth to your heart. And you must pray to Him to abide with you. And you must cherish Him in your soul. You must delight yourself in Him. You must live in Him. You must yield yourself to Him. You must trust Him.
gbagbo.
And you must commune with him.
Ma ba soro.
You must consider him as your friend.
Wo ma mu gege bi ore re.
You must consider him as your guide.
Mu gege bi alabo re.
You must consider him as your tutor.
Mu gege bi oluko re.
You must consider him as your comforter.
Ati gege bi olutunu re.
Number 4.
Elekerin.
Believe not everything.
Ma se gba ohun gbogbo gbo.
But test everything with the word of God.
Ṣugbọn fi oro Olorun gbọ ohun gbogbo wo.
Believe not everything.
Ma gbọ ohun gbogbo gbo.
But test them with the word of God.
Ṣugbọn dọ wọn wo nipa oro Olorun.
Number 5.
Elekarun.
Have a strong decision and conviction.
Ni aridaju ti o le ati ipinu ti o ni agbara.
I know what I have believed.
Mo mọ nkan ti mo ti gbagbọ.
That it is the truth.
Pe otito ni.
And nothing can take it away from me.
Ohun ko si le ba lowo mi.
That is a strong decision and conviction.
Eyi ni imi lokan le to tati ipinu to le.
What is the need of that conviction?
Kini ohun ti a nilo fun nkan yi.
It is that thing.
Nkan yen gan.
That will not make you to be afraid.
Ohun ni ko ni je ki o beru.
When the first prophet come with their teaching.
Ti olukọ eke ba wa pelu eko eke re.
You know today.
Se pe loni.
Today.
Loni.
I must be sincere with you.
Mo ni lati so titọ fun wa.
And I want to tell you.
Mo le so fun wa.
Anything you do for God.
Ohun to ba se for Olorun.
Not out of love.
Ti ko wa lati ni ife.
For the price he has paid on the cross.
Fun awon iyebiye ni irupo to le so lori gagbelebu.
But you are doing it.
Mo wo se.
But because you don't want to go to hell.
Tori pe oh fe lo ran padi.
You don't do it as a pleasant service.
Oh se gege bi isin to 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 ye.
You take God as a hard master.
O mo Olorun gege bi oluko ti o le.
Your services are full of fear and not love to him.
Awon ise re awon ise ran se re ise isin re o ku fun iberu ko se fun ife.
Of course the Bible say we have to work out our salvation with fear and trembling.
Lo to bi le pe ki a mu igbalawa daju pẹ̀lú ìbẹ̀rù àti ìmọ̀lọ́kọ̀lé.
But this area is different entirely.
Ṣùgbọ́n ibi tá à ń sọ yìí ó yàtọ̀ gedegbe.
They can do anything.
Wọ́n lè ṣe ohunkóhun.
Because they don't want to go to hell.
Nítorí wọn fẹ́ lọ ra páàdì.
Not because Christ died for them.
Kì í ṣe pé Kristi kú fún wọn.
Such people.
Irú àwọn ènìyàn bẹ́ẹ̀.
They believe everything.
Wọ́n máa gbọ́ ohun gbogbo.
They believe everything.
Wọ́n á gbọ́ ohun gbogbo.
With fear.
Pẹ̀lú ìbẹ̀rù.
Although they are doing it o.
Lóòótọ́ wọ́n ṣe.
But.
Ṣùgbọ́n.
It does not come from the heart.
Kò wá láti inú ọkàn.
They are just forcing themselves.
Ọkàn mi yọra wọn lẹ́nu.
Àwọn tó bá yẹ agree now to God.
Ohun tó bá ṣe fún Ọlọ́run.
Not willingly.
Tí o fi gbogbo ọkàn ṣe.
Does not come from your heart.
Kò wá láti inú ọkàn rẹ.
You do not do it with joy as the Bible says.
Ṣé pẹ̀lú ọkàn ọkàn ayọ̀ bíbélì yìí sọ fún wa.
It's a waste of time.
Ó jẹ́ ìfẹ́ àkókò ṣòfò.
Such people will be disappointed.
Irú ènìyàn bẹ́ẹ̀ àwọn ènìyàn bẹ́ẹ̀ wọ̀n yìí.
When they died.
Wọ́n á ní ojú àti wọn nígbà tó bá kú.
I pray.
N gbàdúrà.
That we always realize.
Pé a ó máa mọ̀.
And appreciate the death of Christ for you.
A ó sì máa mú ikú Kristi nání nínú ayé wa.
But you always have that visions of the death of Christ at your view.
A bá ní ìran ikú Kristi ní ojú wa.
That vision of Calvary.
Ìran àgbélébu Calvary.
You will not want to do anything that will provoke God, that will allow that man suffering on the cross to go back again and suffer.
Oh, nípa ìgbà ọkùnrin ni kí ó padà sórí igi àgbélébu àti máa.
But even though men seen the fire of hell burning with their eyes, they will go into sin.
Lè pé tọ́yìn bá ní tó bá rí iná wọn àpáàdì tó bá ń jó lójú wọn báyìí wọ́n ṣì máa lọ sínú ẹ̀ṣẹ̀.
I know a man that had the revelations.
Mo mọ ọkùnrin kan tí ó rí ìfihàn.
Of heaven and hell.
Tí ọ̀run rírà tọ́run àpáàdì.
And is committing fornication here about adultery. Ó
wá ń ṣe káàkiri.
But since he has saw a revelation.
Ó ti rí ìfihàn.
Then that means since he knows how people are crying there.
Nígbà tó mọ bí àwọn ẹ̀ṣẹ̀ ń ké níbẹ̀.
How people are suffering.
Bọ́n ṣe ń jìyà.
And tàṣe water and all that.
Pọ̀npọ̀rọ̀ ò ń bẹ bẹ́ẹ̀ lọ.
Such a person should not go back to the things of the world.
Ti irú ènìyàn bẹ́ẹ̀ kò yẹ kó padà sínú ayé o.
Even going into adultery.
Kódà nínú àgbèrè pàṣágà.
But.
Ṣùgbọ́n.
When you do not have the vision of Calvary.
Tí o bá rí ìran Calvary.
When you don't always see Christ on the cross.
Tí o bá rí Kristi ní gbogbo ìgbà lórí àgbélébu.
You can do anything.
O lè ṣe ohunkóhun.
To displace him.
Láti máa wùn.
Despite that you know that you are going to hell if you do it.
Ṣé mo pé o máa rọra pàdé tó bá ṣe.
Lastly.
Lákòótán o.
Have no fellowship with the preachers of heresies.
Máa ṣe ní ìbáṣepọ̀ pẹ̀lú àwọn olùkọ́ àyídáyidà.
Have no fellowship with the preachers of heresies.
Máa ṣe ní ìbáṣepọ̀ pẹ̀lú àwọn olùkọ́ èké.
You must try and do everything to separate yourself from anyone that is preaching heresies.
Oh, Buddha, biyanju ko yere ko lodo eni tikeni to nwasu epo ike.
Any ministry or churches preaching heresies, you must run away from there.
Ida bi ise ranse to ba nwasu ida ida sacred nibe.
Try to enlighten them. If they will not listen, leave that place.
Ri daju pe o fe ri pe o si won loye sugbon to ba ri won fe gbo ko nibe.
By doing that, you will keep the truth that you have heard and that you have known. It is my prayer. The Lord will help you to take it unto the truth. To keep the truth. To love the truth. To think of the truth. To delight in the truth. And to obey the truth. And lastly, to put the truth into practice. The Lord will help us in Jesus' name. Let's bend our feet and talk to God. Oh Lord, help me to obey the truth. Help me to follow the truth. Help me to adore the truth. Help me to exalt the truth. Help me to consecrate myself for the truth. To think of the truth. To preach the truth. To meditate on the truth. To delight in it. To circulate it. To spread it. And to tell everybody. And to practice it. And that by my practice of truth, in my community, in my environment, in my country, men will begin to change. Men will begin to change. Men will begin to change. Let's open our mouth and talk to God.
Shall we tell God that God should give us the grace to live by the truth? Let us open our mouth and tell God that, Lord Jesus, give me the grace.